I'll call this Monday evening, August 19th, Commissioners meeting. We're going to have Casey from the Auditor's Office, all three Commissioners, and the County Attorney. Start off with the agenda, Mayor. You have anything, any updates you want to?
Man, then you must have something about this.
I figured you're a busy guy, things to do, I'll help you get you out of here.
Yeah, no, I'm here for the duration, so I don't really have anything at this point.
Okay.
I guess the only thing I would say is we did start clearing that woods today, eating the hotels in preparation for the road, which, you know, that's down the road, I mean, that's hard to find down the road. But we do hope to have it finished by May or June next year, but we started the process today, so.
Oh, good.
We're excited to get something happening here.
Yeah, getting started. Good deal. Okay. Then we have department updates, so, John Geyer. You're not in your own spot.
I think he got beat out.
I was going to say.
Sneeze, you lose, or you show up.
A little too late, Tina. It starts filling up at 5:30.
I guess so. Meetings are getting popular. Good evening. I've got several permits. The first one I got is permit request 2433. Richard and Lisa Jones are requesting driveway permit at 5991 North Lake Shore Drive, Macy. And they're requesting 20-foot wide driveway. John went out to look. He didn't see any issues with it.
Okay. Hearing no issues, I'll entertain a motion to permit approve permit 2433.
So moved.
Second.
Next one I have is permit request 2434 from Leah France of Wabash Valley Power Association. She's requesting permit at 2725 East 200 North, Rochester, approximately 292 feet west of State Road 25 on 200 North. They're wanting to put in 168 foot driveway. We want to check this out. They're going to need a 4-inch culvert minimum.
Entertain a motion to approve permit 2434 unless there's any questions.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
All in favor? Motion carries 3-0.
Next one I have is permit request 2434 from Miller Pipeline on behalf of NIPSCO. They're wanting to retire and put in a new existing, or replace it with a new service at 1160 West 6th Street. It's a bore.
You good with everything?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And entertain a motion to approve permit 2435.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor? Carries 3-0.
Next one is permit request 2436, again from Miller Pipeline on behalf of NIPSCO. And they're wanting to retire and replace the retirement with a new line at 808 West 9th Street. Again, it's a 4.
Just replacing an old one, right?
Yes. That's what all these are.
Make a motion to approve.
Oh, yeah. I'll second it.
All in favor?
This be right, and I got the side track.
And the last one I have is permit request 2437 for Miller Pipeline, again on behalf of NIPSCO. And they want to do the same thing at 748 West 9th Street. Two houses down.
A bunch of them here, don't we?
Yes, they do.
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries 3-0.
So while we're talking about permits, I want to tell you about a permit that we approved, I don't know, a month or two ago on Old 31 North for Comcast. It was to bore a cable in along 31. It was to be 3 foot off of the back fence on the right of way. And they bored it 3 foot off the edge of the road.
Yeah.
Put their pedestals right at the edge of the road.
I wondered about that.
I contacted them and they're going to move things.
That was a question I was going to ask about those pedestals. They're that close to the road, so.
It's not going to fly.
Yeah.
I mean, we'll go through there with snowplow, widen the road out, we'll take them out.
That's what I thought.
We widen the road, which our intentions are to put buggy lanes on that road in the near future. They'd be right on top of them, so. We Comcast gracefully said they have the contractor remove things.
Is what it is.
Yep.
They realized the mistake right away. While we're talking about Old 31, I do have air marking. They're going to come out and stripe it probably first of next week, from what I heard. If they haven't already done it, I haven't been up there.
You're talking north?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Okay.
Did they do it?
No, I haven't seen it.
I didn't know.
They didn't when we come down.
But they're planning on doing that very, very soon up to the bridge and Old 31, or Olson Road between Old and New 31. North of the bridge, we're going to do after we go in and mill out the bumps. I'm going to do that. I got a contractor coming in to do some milling, take those sharp bumps off. Once that's done, we repair them, we'll stripe it. So just wanted to give you an update in case somebody contacts you about it. It's in the works. Other than that, guys have been patching holes, running the brush cutter. They completed chip seal last week and started pugging right away. So they're going to pug right now, laying it. They got about a mile done in 3 days, so that was pretty good.
Pretty good.
Old 31 South, that project's pretty well completed, and on the 5th of September, at the intersection of Old and New, New 31 there on the south side, there's a little pull-off. We're going to meet with NDOT, MSI, and Fenton Brown, and go through the final inspection on that. And that's at 10 o'clock, I believe.
What day is that?
Next Thursday.
Next Thursday?
Yeah, the 5th of September.
September.
Yeah. Community crossings projects, I talked with Brooks Construction today. They're going to start on 900 West tomorrow, north of DeLong there, Olson Road up to 110. They're going to start on that tomorrow and then work their way over to 600 and 400. And then after the holiday, they're going to do Lake Bruce. So those will be getting done here pretty quick.
Good deal.
So, you know, Old 30, or State Road 14 still closed, or kind of closed. They got traffic flowing through it. But, they're on delay on that. NDOT held that project up because of pavement design. So they're a couple weeks out and then they're going to start milling it. We're going to start receiving the millings on there. And then hopefully make short work of that. We're way behind on that project.
And we're all going to Kiwanis.
Mm-hmm. The detour we had here south of town on 25, that's been opened up, that bridge is open. And I'm supposed to meet with NDOT, I think, next week and go through the bypass and that the detour we had and slip for damage.
Is there some damage? Somebody thought there was a little bit of damage.
There's a little. It's not obsessive, but.
Looked like a little on the west side of the road. There's a couple of spots there.
Mm-hmm. Compared to last time, I mean, they destroyed the road last time. I did want to present to you tonight an LPA consulting contract. We had our bridge scoring. USI won the scoring. And I've got a LPA consulting contract for that Old 31 North project, which is in 5 years.
Just how we see that? It's how I see
it. I sent our copy.
It's standard bowler for you, right?
But yes.
So you guys have any questions on the grant? Okay. Well, I entertain a motion to approve the consulting contract with USI.
So moved.
Second. All in favor? Motion carries 3-0.
Should have the mark where they need sign. We'll see tonight, I believe, a couple appropriation requests from the highway. One's for $94,000 from MVH to Capital Outlays, and that's to cover the expenses of the new backhoe that we bought. And then the second one's $190,000 That's to add extra funds into bituminous for road projects and the millings that we're purchasing and stuff like that. We shop the year.
And that's out of your MVH?
Yes.
Have you got your backhoe?
Yes. We've got it, in service. Working real nice. Guys like it better than the old one. I mean, just, it's got a lot of features and its capabilities are a lot better than the old one. It's a good machine, good match for them. While we're talking about money, got a couple things I wanted to talk about. One is the salt roof over Kiwana. I talked to the council here last meeting, a month ago, told them I was going to pay for that. After the first of the year, we was going to try to get it done over November, December, pay for it with new funds next year. I was over there last week when it was raining real hard. That thing's leaking like a sieve. That roof's not going to hold up. We got, you know, $50,000 to $100,000 of salt in there. We need to do something with it. So
how quick can you get him on it?
He could get on it probably in October, if not sooner. Big thing is getting, you know, moving the money around or figuring out. That's a council question, I know. Figuring out how to pay for it.
Couple of them in here.
Is there a couple more?
Yeah, you don't mind working for free for a couple of them.
Well, that's a good solution. You don't want to go anywhere this winter either.
Yeah, Brandy, you're here too. Yeah, go talk to them, see what they have to say.
And then while we're talking about that, we did talk to you guys and them last meeting also last month about siding that building. They was going to pay for the siding through rainy day. This is the side, the main shop at the highway garage here in Rochester. Which we've got that pretty well lined up. Brian and I talked, we thought insulating that right now, spray foaming that with insulation would be a good deal. Again, this is more of a council question if they can afford it, but if you guys are all right with it, I'll present that to them tomorrow night. We did get a quote for it. It's not cheap. It was about, what, $24,000, I think?
Oh, it's 20.
Between 20 and 20, I think.
And the ceiling is 19.8 or something.
Yeah. It was 19.8. And then I think you put on here, add 4,000 if you went thicker.
So what's the bottom line?
Probably 23,000. Okay. 19 or 23,000.
I think it'd be a smart idea, but still, you gotta see if they got the money. I mean, that's. You guys agree? Do you agree, Dave?
Yep. Yeah, the exterior walls was 20 to the outside. It'd be a lot easier to do before you sell your money.
Yeah, you're not gonna be able to do it after that.
So save your money in the long run.
Yeah. One thing about that building, it's just blocked. There is no insulation in there.
Yeah, no problem.
It's been that way since the 40s, but we spend a lot of money on heat in the winter. If you're gonna put, obviously we can't afford to put up a new building right away. If you're gonna stay in that one, you might as well.
Gotta keep it up.
But again, that's another council question. I just wanted to bring it before you. Mm-hmm. And then these guys here, they can hear it and kind of ponder over it.
Yeah.
Okay. Another thing I got for you is a letter. This is the way I like spending money tonight.
Geez, God.
That's not hard for us.
We just look out at Chase.
We just look out at Chase and Steve, and they just shake their hands.
We had the oil spill out there at the county this summer. I reached out to Luke Smith, who's 50% of one of the tenants, and was brother or cousin Travis farm that together. I asked him to give me an itemized bill of what he thought it would crop damages were. He sent that $4,800 total was the amount he sent, which I don't think is too unreasonable.
I saw that. I mean, that's going to be the ballpark.
I guess I'm looking at Holly and you both, but how's that going to work? I mean, do we go ahead and pay it? Is it an insurance claim?
I was going to ask you, did it? Was the insurance ever contacted?
Yes, and last I talked to them, they had it all under review. And that was my correspondence with them.
Okay, so we need to find out from the insurance company if they're going to pay anything. I mean, I don't think they should.
Say that again. $10,000, right? $10,000 deductible?
Yeah.
So you're going to pay some of it, so.
Well, that's all, is this all the amount there is?
Oh, no.
Oh, okay.
There's other expenses, but this is the only expense to the tenant.
Okay, all right.
I agree with you. I don't think it's totally out of line, and I don't have a problem with it. It's just, do we pay it? Do we insurance? You're going to find out if the insurance is going to pay first, or if we can pay and turn in the bill and go towards our deductible?
I think you need to contact the insurance company first and find out where they're at in all of this, and what they're going to pay. And then if this comes in under the deductible, you'll have to pay.
Do we want to have a motion to approve paying this based on insurance? I mean, if insurance doesn't, we do. If insurance covers it, we let them.
I mean, it's all part of claims.
So yeah.
Yeah, it'll all be locked in together. So.
Yeah, we got to pay it. I mean,
I guess the motion of approval of the
expense. You could do a motion of this amount.
$4,800.
Yeah, of the actual amount. Yeah.
Then in the future, if we have to pay it,
we're locked into the $4,800.
Yeah, we submit a claim for it. If not, we let insurance take care of it.
So if we make the approval of this, and then either we pay it or pay it, and then if it is covered in the claim, just to get the bill insurance for to go into the deductible, otherwise we'll stand.
I'll make a motion to approve this bill from Luke Smith for $4,800 for crop damage.
I'll second. Any other questions on that?
I think you need to add it pending insurance.
I made a motion just like she said it, pending insurance.
I'll second the same motion. I like what Rick said.
We'll see what insurance does.
Yep. Okay.
I think that's all I have for you tonight.
Okay.
I hope so.
Yeah, kind of enough money.
Yeah.
I don't have anything. Else?
I don't get anything. Thanks, John. Thank you.
We'll jump ahead.
Might as well. Barry, you still there?
Hello.
Okay.
So we have the appointments of the 911 director and the EMA director. So you want to have any say on anything?
Yes, both the EMA director's position and the 911 director's position was vacated. When Gail retired, and I worked with the county's HR director, Christina, to update the job descriptions and post those jobs according to county policy. I can't say enough good about Christina and the work that she did to help facilitate that entire process up through the interview. So I'm not sure if she's there this evening or not, but I don't always have an HR director that is engaged, or the county may not have an HR director. And so I really appreciated that. Both positions were posted on the 23rd of July. They were posted for the 7-day period. They were made public thereafter. We did a statewide posting on a job board for both positions through the associations that represent either 911 or EMA. We had five applicants for the 911 director's position. It's six applicants for EMA. A couple of those applied for both. We had one who applied but didn't tell us what they were applying for. So we have a wide variety there. First, I'll start with the 911 director's position. The commissioners met in executive session last Thursday on the 16th, interviewed two qualified applicants for the position of 911 director. Spent a great deal of time in discussion with both individuals about their experience, their training, their certifications, their goals and objectives for managing the PSAP in the future, budget experience, just a wealth of information was exchanged. Both candidates had an opportunity to ask questions of the commissioners and HR in that meeting. And at the time that we concluded those interviews, I believe that commissioners were prepared to make a recommendation at this public meeting and take action on naming a new 911 director.
Go back to Brian now.
Yeah, do you want to do these individually?
Yeah. Okay. Let's just do, do 911. Okay. So, do I have a recommendation for the 911 director? For Brittany Thompson. Okay. Second on that?
Second.
Okay. I guess Brittany's here, so she takes the job of that.
All right, about got choked up on
that. Okay. I have a motion and a second. All in favor? Motion carries 3-0. I guess pending Brittany's approval, accepting the offer. So, okay.
You do accept it, right?
That's correct.
Okay. So we have and Brittany's the 911 coordinator. Congratulations. Welcome forward. Okay, Barry, if you want to do any of that.
Commissioners, Brittany will follow up with you in regards to a start date and working with the commissioners and HR for that to take place. My contract with the county is still in place. That is, Brittany is onboarded in any training that may be needed is there. With Brittany being a previous employee of the 911 center, she was a deputy director, she was the IDEX coordinator. Being able to renew her certifications in the disciplines should not be any issue and should be able to be accomplished in a timely manner upon her becoming the employee. So we'll be working with that. The second position was for the EMA director. In the afternoon of August 16th, last Thursday, the EMA advisory board, a representation of that board met and co-chaired by Jerry and by Dave. I see some of the advisory board members in the audience this evening. They too interviewed two qualified applicants, spent a great deal of time exchanging a lot of information, hearing about their particular goals and objectives, their credentials in emergency management, and what they believed was in the best interest of Fulton County moving forward in EMA. The advisory board left those interviews, I believe, prepared for either Dave or Jerry to make a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners this evening.
Okay, you want me? Me too.
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Okay. we met and then we had further discussions on Friday and Saturday concerning the position, and upon final analysis, we recommend Don Sewell for the EMA position.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll take your recommendation and I'll make the motion that we appoint Don Zuhl as EMA Director.
Okay, so second, okay. Any other questions? Okay, all in favor? Motion carries 3-0, and Don accepting it.
Where's she at? You good?
Okay, Barry, I want to thank you for all the work you've done and helped us through all this. So.
Do you want to keep him on through the for this yet? Yeah.
We can only ask him real quick. We have the, it's a boilerplate that we've done with Akron.
I think I sent it to you a little bit ago, Barry. Did you get the email a little bit ago?
Is that on the user agreement for Spillman?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, I think I saw that come in. Yes, I have it right here.
Do you need a minute or are you?
I would ask the you or legal counsel if that MOU for Spillman is following the same format that you would have MOUs with any of the outlying law enforcement agencies or anyone else in the county.
Yes, it has. And I have spoken to the sheriff about it also, and it's very similar to the other ones.
Yeah, based on that and it being just the user agreement of the Spillman software, I think that document would be okay for you to proceed with tonight. And then the other issue that we had been pending and tabled with the new 911 director coming on board, that's one of the areas that we need to talk to her about with the city and the mayor.
Okay.
Sounds good.
All right. So then we have the MOU here for between Fulton County and the city of Rochester for the use of the Spillman software and database for the amount of $5,000. And like I said, it's basically the same thing we've done for Akron and Kiwana or Pibble?
Akron and Kiwana. I basically copied that one.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So is there any other questions on that? Any questions?
Yeah.
Okay. I'd entertain a motion then to enter into that contract, that MOU with the city for the amount of $5,000.
So moved.
Second. All in favor? Motion carries. I'll try to sign that. So.
Yep.
Okay. That's for Barry.
Yep. I think so.
Barry, I appreciate everything.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity. Have a good evening.
Appreciate your help and the insight on those interviews.
Thank you.
Okay.
You want to shut that down or?
That's what we keep an eye on the audience.
Okay.
All right.
Just
Fulton, we'll let you get up here.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Tomorrow, I'll be in Kokomo doing in the morning for the second half of the Korean culture training discussion. This time, instead of first responders, it's going to wind up being with community leaders, business people. Again, all that this amounts to is it's a discussion of the Korean culture. It's not about changing anything or bypassing our laws or anything. At some point, they're taping these, and at some point, we should have access to them. And once we get access to them, I'll make them available to anybody who wants to come in and view them, deal with that. Same day, later in the afternoon, there's going to be a discussion with NDOT about trying to find an easier access point to Jim Strader's property along with the Cromwell property. Jim wants certain ways for it to go in. There's a lot of discussion about three or four different opportunities to get into that property. So that's what we'll be doing later in the afternoon. Wednesday, let's go to the housing project. We have, I believe it's five developers looking at properties. Our housing group is going to be meeting on Wednesday morning with a collection of business leaders that we've done a special invite to. They're going to tell us what they need. And we will take that kind of information, boil it down, and our project will be what Rochester needs and Fulton County needs, because we're looking at some sites outside in the county at this point too. So we're going to build to the housing study. And the others probably will wind up with what I call cookie cutter. They're going to run their projects type of thing. More on that once we get that taken care of. Let's see, what else? There's, we put in, we hustled up, put in requests for the Lilly money, light removal and arts and culture. And then I got an email that they missed the deadline at the Regional Planning Commission. And so we have a September 1 deadline for both projects at this point. I put in specifically for Putz, but this time we're going to put in for the whole downtown area and the county at the same time. I'm asking about $500,000 at that point, which means we're going to have to come up with some match money, which means I'm working on getting a grant writer to research out grants for us. So hopefully that'll be where our match money comes in from. The next thing I think you'll be happy to hear is we'll have a hotel study probably by the end of the first week of September. Then we'll know what's going on. But the real thing that I think you'll be happy about is I'm talking to NIPSCO on Blackener, and sometime in October they'll be able to tell us when they're going to put the gas line in. And at the same time, I'm talking to a company about selling four lots at Blackener. That would leave us with three. That's where it stands right now.
Okay. Thanks, Mike. Okay. Kathy, Treasurer, anything?
Nope, everything's going good, other than just letting you guys know I will be on vacation next week. I will be out of state. Okay. Other than that, she's in charge next week.
Enjoy your vacation.
Yep. Thank you.
And Dawn, EMA.
Not a whole lot since the last commissioner's meeting. One thing that I want to bring forth is the Everbridge contract I brought to you about 2 months ago. We are locked into that. We are going to have to stay with it for one more year. So I do have the money in the budget to take care of that so that we can get into it. So last week I attended, along with some of the other officials here in the county, the city. And it was a Manitow Dam exercise. It was a tabletop exercise. Really good light brought to the Manitow Dam. And in conjunction with that, I will also be going to, in September, the floodplain storm management, emergency management, for that also in conjunction. And hopefully be able to bring back a couple of things that we talked about in the tabletop, bringing forward here for commissioners. Election is coming around. We have a Homeland Security gentleman coming in tomorrow morning, and we'll be meeting with me, well, with myself, representative from the Sheriff's Department. I don't know if she got a word or not, Andy. 9:30 tomorrow morning in the basement. Homeland Security is coming in tomorrow and going over. We attended a meeting last week in Fort Wayne. And for cybersecurity, and I know Josh is coming to that meeting also. So we'll be going through some things for the election concerning security-wise, cybersecurity, and things like that. Heating cooling meeting tomorrow, I've got with Amy. We will be going to Warsaw tomorrow after I get done with the election. Be going to Warsaw with Amy and checking on the heating and cooling facility they have up there in Warsaw. So I'll be gone for a little bit during that span tomorrow too. For those in the businesses here in the county, LAPC, we're having a lunch and learn. Jerry will probably hit on that too in a minute. LAPC is doing lunch and learn on Wednesday at the fairgrounds for the businesses from 11 to 12:30. That evening, Albany's having a helicopter landing there at Albany for their helicopter training landing for those here in the community who might want to go and see that also. And then we have the parade coming up on the 31st. The EMA will be involved all the way around. Volunteers have already been, we got about four or five things coming up, including football games. So our volunteers will be busy. If you know anybody that wants to volunteer, let us know. So thank you, gentlemen, for the opportunity coming to serve forth with EMA here in Fulton County. So, and thank you to my EMA board for recommendations. Thank you, guys.
Get in touch with HR.
I will.
So you see what she's gonna, if she needs anything else from you.
Okay, thank you, gentlemen.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hey, Casey Hensley, assessor.
I don't have anything. I am going to shoot out an email to you guys, though, about some things, some ideas to streamline some things and have some better communication with some departments. So other than that, I've got nothing.
Okay. Amy.
Like Don said, we're going to be tomorrow bringing a couple of the additional pastors who have stepped up to do the temporary heating and cooling station. So at the last pastor's meeting, we had a couple additional pastors who have stepped up to the plate to potentially provide opportunity to address that need. So we'll meet with those guys and Don to take that into the next level. So slow but steady wins the race. I wish it was already decided, but you just have to get all the details. So while Trent and the other team are working on the permanent solution, we're working on the temporary because the permanent solution will be not ready by the winter. In addition, this week on Wednesday, that's the 21st, I believe so, I had a board meeting on Friday and spoke to the Beeman Home board as well as the interim director. And due to circumstances here in the city of Rochester, even though we don't have permanent solutions figured out for staffing, they are going to allow us to have an individual here in Fulton County every other week. So that individual will start on Wednesday. And so they will be here all day Wednesday and then every other week. So
Where will she be at?
So right now, the Recovery Cafe has asked that she be there. So we are going to test that and see if that works. She will be introduced at the Fulton County Hope Quarterly meeting on Wednesday that we are having. I've already introduced her to Rachel Arndt in the prosecutor's office because we do not have a victim's assistance individual. I did not realize that. So her name is Rachel, have already connected today. So this is the first step. Hopefully we can then figure out the funding for a full-time or a part-time to full-time person at some point, but at least getting that conversation started, having that person here available for anybody who is in need of services. So it's a nice next step to be able to help address individuals. I've seen an increase in domestic violence on the police report when Andy gives that at City Council. So providing some resources, maybe not a perfect solution, but it's a start. And so that's pretty exciting. And then as far as Dora that I presented, I've been really grateful to Julie and Jillian and Casey for all the research that they've been able to help me with. So we will probably have two ordinances that we will tentatively present for just review. And then if we get some support there and feel like we've gotten things settled, I will bring that back to the next commissioner's meeting for you guys to review before we actually move forward with the council. So slow but ready, steady wins the race there too as well. So just making sure we get all the details organized and move forward. So doing a lot of conversation and stuff.
Sounds good.
Lots of good things happening.
Okay. Thanks, Amy. Yeah. Jerry.
Good evening. Can I just talk from right here?
Sure.
Okay, thanks. I just wanted to give you an update. This is breaking news from our registrar down at Vital Records, Carrie Ranstead. To date, we've had 97 deaths experienced here in the county. Of that, 52 females and 45 males. The manners of death, I will tell you, most of them are, of course, natural. About 86, we've had 4 suicides, 6 accidental deaths, and 1 homicide. And then we've got about 3 that are pending our autopsy results, waiting on that. And we've got 2, we're waiting toxicology. So once we get all those bits of information plugged in, then we can determine those causes to go along with the ones we have. And as you can see, the coroner does investigate. We're still holding it, investigating about 35 or 36% of all the deaths that occur here in the county. Let me see. And our coroner's calls, totally, we've had 35 for the year that we've helped families with. Of that, we've had 14 females and 21 males. So that's a little bit about our statistics and where we stand. Our death rate in the county is down this year. We're thankful for that. That's a good thing. I know the birth rate's up. I will tell you that. But I do know that with our births, we are an oasis here in Fulton County, a maternity oasis. So we've got people coming in from other counties too. So that might be a little bit skewed a little bit. It's not just Fulton County people, but I wanted to let you know that too, that our birth rate's up. On September 27th, I'll be attending the coroner's training board meeting in Indianapolis, hopefully. I've got the paperwork ready. I'll probably send it to you, but I do not have an agenda. We'll be reviewing and doing our after action report of our conference back in June. So it was very successful, but we do like to keep things tweaked and keep things interesting. So I wanted to let you know that. And like Don already mentioned, we're all excited about the Lunch and Learn coming up on Wednesday this week. Tony Passarisi's our leader on that. He does an amazing job, and he's cultivated a lot of new partners with Tier 2 in our county. So we're excited to get them included, because that only helps our county basis and foundation for safety. So wanted to let you know that, and so we're looking forward to it, and it's almost here. We've been planning for it for several months, but he's led the pack and did a fantastic job. Any questions? Thank you very much.
Sounds good, Jerry. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Crystal.
Just have 2 things. Newest dispatcher, we got her certified in the MD, and I did post the job opening on Indeed, got several applications. I have put those in a folder for
Thank you. Okay. Jill, get you in Fulton County Chamber. We're kind of rolling out of
here. I'm going to be visiting the Oasis here in a couple of weeks.
Okay.
Thank you for letting me come in again. It's been a few months since my last update, so I thought I'd just let you know what's happening in Chamber and tourism land. When we talked this spring, we were just starting what we called a total resource campaign as a way to give new opportunities to our members. That went really well. We had 77 businesses find opportunity and value in that. So we have been implementing those all year long, and we'll continue to do that through next June. A couple of things that have come out of that is a new newsletter called the Chamber Insider. We're sending that out every other week on Monday, and that is available to all of our members to advertise it. I know the city just took advantage of that with the survey for their Parks and Recreation Department. The county is able to do that as well as many of our members in here. So if you guys have anything, we're trying to I have a touch point with all of the businesses in the community, and you can do that through that newsletter, and that's twice a month. And then we also have a new social media campaign called Where Are We Wednesdays, where we're just going out throughout the county and visiting different businesses, and they've really appreciated that. So we'll continue to do that through next June as well. The marketing committee Last time I talked, we were putting together welcome bags. They are put together. So these are what we're distributing to new residents and anyone that's moving back to Fulton County. We've put together 50 of these bags. When I say we, there's a committee of six marketing professionals. Hannah Bainey, Erica Coffing, Leslie Bowers, Chris Azimek, Krista Foster, and myself. We get together monthly, put these bags together, distributed them to all of the title companies, real estate offices, and mortgage lenders in the county. I know they've already given out several of them, but it's just a way to say hello and welcome and to help people feel at home right away. So we did have several businesses that have advertised in there, so you'll see some that, whether it's home repair or retailers that have put some goodies in there, but then it's just a variety of resources such as where our parks located, how can people get involved through service clubs, different organizations, who are the local trustees, who do they need to talk to. So all of that is in that bag just to help people feel more welcome right away. We also have extra bags available at our office, so if there's an employer who's looking to do some professional recruitment, they can use those bags as a way to help people feel acclimated to the county. A couple of things that we're working on right now and upcoming events. As you know, the Chili Cook-Off and Car Show is right around the corner, October 12th. I'll come back from me for that. Looking ahead, we're working with, I'll need about 120 volunteers for the day, so to juggle both of those events. We're making good progress. The thing that we're looking for right now is chili teams. That's really what makes it successful. So that registration process is open through September 16th. We do have all of the notes, everything as far as rules, regulations, et cetera, on our website. But anyone who's interested in being involved, it's a really good outreach program for nonprofits. It's good exposure for employers. But we really need those teams in order to make that event successful. And then just because I know it's always asked, what do we need from the county? I don't think I have any requests for the event. The only thing I'll say is, and I'll talk to Carrie, is if you could make sure it looks nice. That way when people come to town, we do have about 8,000 people that come to downtown Rochester. We don't use the courthouse lawn. We won't ask for that, but we would like to make it presentable and have people enjoy our area and have them be, just be proud of where they are. So that'll be my only request, I think. The Fulton County Leadership Academy, in conjunction with Purdue Extension, is accepting enrollment through Wednesday. So if anybody is interested in participating in FCLA this year, make sure you sign up by Wednesday, and classes actually start next Tuesday. Let's see, tourism, we're just same old at this point. We did distribute, and I brought these for you, our RAC cards. We purchased 10,000. 8,000 of them have gone to different travel destination locations, rest areas throughout the state. So many trips to UPS and a lot of postage, but we got them all out, about 8,000. So just trying to promote Fulton County the best that we can. On our operations side, we've experienced a lot of rising costs lately, and we are trying to keep our membership dues down. So we're looking for creative, unique ways to be able to diversify our income stream. We do continue to get hundreds of phone calls and referrals every month. So we're just working on how can we make sure that we're open, we're here, we're available for not only the business community, but the general public is looking for information, keeping our costs down as much as possible. So just so you know that. 19 new members this year, 6 ribbon cuttings. We have a couple more before the end of the year. So making progress in the county. And then the last thing, just some of the upcoming events, and these are all between now and when I come back from maternity leave, so we'll see how it goes. We have a State of the Schools luncheon next Monday at the library. Both Mrs. Vance and Mrs. Miller will be speaking, and we'll go through past year successes, challenges, as well as their outlook for this year. How they're developing students for the workforce, how to keep them engaged in the community, and various structure changes within the school district. So that's next Monday. We do need registration for that if anybody's interested in attending. So make sure you register by Wednesday or Thursday. I think it's Wednesday. We'll have lunch, and that'll be at the library for Monday. We do have a Business Connectors lunch September 11th out at the museum. That's a free event for our chamber members. We cap out at 40 every quarter. Those are well attended, very popular, so just a good way for business leaders to get together and to network. And then our Fall Women in Business event will be Wellness for the Working Woman on November 1st. We'll have a panel of speakers, Jessica Riffle with Purdue Extension, Lisa Willis-Gidley with 4C Health, and Kelly McCall with Elevate Studio, all talking about our wellness, how to take care of ourselves as working women. So that'll be coming up November 1st. And then lastly, we're gearing up for small business season, which kicks off with Small Business Saturday, November 30th. We'll do another two-week campaign, really encouraging people to shop small, think local before they go to the big box stores for holiday shopping. We'll have a fun game that plays into that. I think we're gonna give away another $500 in chamber dollars. And then we'll continue to do promotions through the end of the year for our small businesses. So, things going on, but wanted to keep you in the loop with what's happening, and thank you for supporting us and just sharing everything that we're doing.
Sounds good. Good luck in the next couple of weeks.
That's right.
Yeah. And Julian, you might want to put that back somewhere. Are you leaving?
I'm leaving.
Okay, you're leaving. Okay.
I'm going to go lay down.
Okay. Well,
Good.
Thank you. Julian, do you have anything?
I can if you want me to. You know that. Our VP, I started maybe 2 months ago as executive director. I'm keeping hours on Wednesday in the barbershop underneath the Chamber of Commerce. Last Wednesday I went out and surveyed Maine, just getting up-to-date information, but also helping on the DORA for the city council. Learning, making sure Main Street signed up like properly in the Main Street programs, doing compliance classes, hiding art for the Times Theater art auction that's coming up on August 30th, keeping very busy, making my rounds at the city meetings, just trying to introduce myself as much as possible, and still going strong at the theater. So as always, call me. Any questions, any ideas, suggestions, we're keeping busy.
Where's your art auction gonna be?
At the theater. Jim Scott donated the entirety of his personal collection of his own work, which will be pretty cool. And all proceeds go directly to the Times Theater, which if we handle this right, could be one of the most generous gifts we've received so far. We've been getting them framed. There will be a $100 price range where you can leave with something in for that price, which is important for his work. And then we'll have a silent auction. And then a fantastic show afterwards, a George Harrison show, and he's actually in London right now playing and then coming to Rochester. He's part of the original Beatlemania. Just kind of a cool networking connection we've made with Nashville, Indiana.
And so, what was the date of that?
Friday, August 30th. It's kind of a kickoff for the Labor Day weekend. And then we'll go into the Nickel Plate weekend, which the parade's gaining tons of speed, which is good. The festival, the bands are wonderful this year. So everyone's in event mode. Duke Tomatoes coming to the theater the day of the chili cook-off, right after. So we thought that kind of goes hand in hand. Some chili and some tomatoes. He hasn't been here for a long time. And we're getting ready to do a Manitow Monster Fest at the theater. Trivia night, like Halloween trivia movies, and then concert to benefit the Jimmy Downs Foundation. So we got a lot coming up.
Good, thank you.
And Dora will help, and the mayor's been so supportive of sidewalk carts, and we've got some small victories coming.
Good.
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 Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. We have an employee that has requested to work from home, special situation, so I entertain a motion to approve that.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries 3-0. Okay. You guys had a chance to look at travel requests over?
Yep.
Any motion to approve those?
Oh, but I'll have to abstain from mine.
Yeah.
And mine too.
Do we know good in that?
Yeah. Okay. On your case, remove all the travel authorizations except Commissioner Ranstad's.
And mine.
Well,
yeah. All of them except.
Except.
Okay.
I'll make the motion.
Okay.
Second.
Come on.
All day, man. So all in favor?
Yeah.
Motion carries 3-0. Okay. And then Dave, I entertain a motion to approve Mr. Ranstad's travel request.
Make motion.
I'll second. All in favor? Motion carries 2-0. I'll make a motion to approve Dave's.
So moved.
All in favor? Motion carries 2-0.
All right.
That was simple. We have the minutes from August 5th and...
just the one, I think.
Just the one?
Yeah.
Yep, just the one.
The 15th.
We took it out for corrections. Okay. I entertain a motion to approve those minutes.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries 3-0. Okay, we have, you guys had a chance to look over Fulton County Transpo's
statement, but
budget and needs approval of that. So, you guys look
that over? Yep, I left it over. Yeah. I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries 3-0. Okay, we have a transfer request. You guys had a chance to look over all the claims, transfers,
yep.
appropriations, if any.
Yep.
Any questions?
Yep.
Okay, we have a transfer request from the park. Office supplies of $50 to printing. Pay for a photo contest deal. So. Okay, we have payroll. 7/26/24 of $276,966.37 with a payroll deduction of $120,388.90. We have payroll claims for 8/9/24 of $273,680.80 with a payroll deduction of $99,183.14. Insurance claim docket for 7/18 to 7/24 of $36,719.61. Insurance docket for 7/25 to 7/31 of $25,913.58. Insurance claim docket for August fees of $53,796.80. Insurance claim docket for 8/1 to 8/7 of 24, $13,651.82. We have utility claim of $8,797.02. The lit distribution claim of $743,615.08. The solid waste district host fee for $731 of $33,333.33. Insurance claim docket for 8-8 to 8-14, $21,796.65.
As quick as possible, but we need to go through some particulars and make sure we're all on the same page, I guess.
We need to make sure Brittany's involved with the sure. meetings on that, so she understands that she's going to be doing it. So.
Okay. I just want an idea. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. We're going to get on it as quick as we can here. So.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, you bet. Okay. Okay. New business?
No.
Okay.
No.
Is it any other new business? Yeah.
It's, well, I don't know if it's really business. It's more of a complaint. I live in Nana Lake.
Okay.
And I came a little bit over 2 years ago to zoning about a property up there on North Sunset Boulevard, 6356. Larry called out. It's a real pigsty. And when I went to zoning, they told me that they would fine him for not cleaning up his property and when it reached $2,000, it'd be turned over to the prosecutor. And to my knowledge, nothing was ever done. So then I went to the health department. And I've been back and forth with the health department. They don't seem to be interested at all. But they did go out there and they talked to Larry and said as long as he had public access to bathroom, because he's had no electricity, no gas, no water, and no sewage for over 4 years now. He's been living on that property. The garage is 4.5 feet deep in garbage bags because he's never had no trash pickup. His basement's even worse than that. I went to the health department and he said he went out there and talked to Larry. Larry told him he had a public restroom at his convenience. And so the health department was okay with that. And he has done absolutely nothing.
Okay. Last Monday, I'm on the area plan board,
mm-hmm.
which is Heather, the one that controls this.
Mm-hmm.
We are her boss on the board, the whole board. We've got a little big member board. That meets, I gotta give you the date, I can't remember. It's always the last Monday of the month, whatever. Somebody got a calendar?
Isn't it this coming Monday?
Yeah, you're on it too.
Yeah.
26th.
The 26th?
Yeah.
The 26th at 7 p.m. in this room.
Okay.
I would come to that meeting and all tell right. the board.
Okay.
The board's absolutely. Her boss will ask her why something ain't been done or
right.
why.
Yeah, I mean, I'm really concerned. You know, the neighbor across the street got cockroaches because he used to go down there all the time. He's got cockroaches. There's rats, there's mice, everything. I mean, my house has been taken over by mice in the wintertime, which I've never had a problem with before, so I know that's where they're coming from. And it's really a health issue up here at that lake.
Yeah.
It really is.
Because she's the one that's got the authority to, like you say, start fining them, and after the fine reaches well, so you know, much, and they don't...
He's not even living there. The lady that lives at the lake, she was real good friends with him. She took him, he had a plan, and he was going to Mississippi on his boat. She took him down to Logansport, actually, 2 weeks ago and dropped him off at Logansport, and he went out to Wabash. He's headed to Mississippi. So he's actually been in the house. It's just sitting there empty right now. But my biggest problem is I don't care if he's living there or he's not living there. I want that mess cleaned up.
Sure.
You know, I've had enough of it. I really have. You know, it's horrible. You can see the pictures.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't go in the house. I wouldn't step foot in that house to begin with to give you guys any picture of what it looks like in there, but I'm sure it's probably even worse. So... You know,
it's
a real concern. It really is.
Bring the pictures and
right.
Monday night, 7 o'clock.
Yep.
7 o'clock.
Yep.
Yeah, a couple more members.
Yep. Yeah.
So.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
You bet. Okay. Okay, anybody else need business? Okay. Any public comment? Okay, hearing none, I entertain a motion to recess.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries.
No,